What is up, fam? Welcome back to Lesley Jones Tarot. Hello, my beautiful, sexy, vibrant Scorpios. All right, we're going to do a whatever comes out message reading for you. Okay, we're just gonna do it. We're just gonna roll with the punches here. All right, so let's see. Let's do Soul's Journey deck first and see what comes out with these for the next 4 to 7 days. What do you have for my Scorpios that you need them to know for the next 4 to 7 days? What is it that you need Scorpio to know for the next 4 to 7 days? General messages, fear. What is it that you need Scorpio to know for the next 4 to 7 days? Scorpio, I see you releasing fear here, okay? Yep. I realize that I am testing my resolve to live in the energy of love. Scorpio, you're releasing the fear to love. You're releasing the fear to show love to people, situations, new beginnings. But I also feel like this has a lot to do with your success and your abundance. Again, guys, it's pretty much the same messages that are coming out, but I'm going to keep doing them, okay? To inspire y'all, to keep pushing y'all to go. Because the next card is success. I know that there is no greater goal than to love. You're on this love vibration, Scorpio, which has a lot to do with this year of 2022. Okay, 2 plus 2 plus 2 is 6. All right, in tarot, 6 represents lovers. Okay, success and recognition as well. So a lot of you are on this love energy. In the month of February, what's February known for? Valentine's Day, you know, and that's about love. So I see a lot of you showing love, giving love. We have envy. I am the same as everybody, but with different challenges. You're letting go of that envy. You're letting go of that anger towards people that have hurt you in the past here. You're focusing on love. You're on this love wavelength here. And because of that, a lot of success and abundance is coming in for you here. All right. A lot of you have dealt with a lot. We have the grief and the doubt card. What's at the top? Growth. But you've overcame it. And you're setting yourself free from any past relationships, because we have growth, freedom, and then we also have failure. So a lot of you are set or releasing yourselves from past situations that no longer serve you, okay? Recognizing that it needed to happen that way, it needed to come to an end that way, and that's okay, okay? That's okay. We just got to keep moving forward here, all right? So what other messages do you have? Let's do Divine Abundance cards here. Let's see. What other messages do you have for my Scorpios? What else is it that you want them to know? Ooh, what? Sacrifice. Sometimes surrender is painful. God's cutting away all that needs to go. Illusions, obsessions, addictions. It is a sacrifice to love. Love. I told y'all, y'all on the energy, the wavelength of love here. You're sacrificing your past is what you're doing. You're letting go of those past commitments, those past situations where you've given all of your energy, time to. You're saying, I'm done. Okay, I'm letting it go. I'm not holding on to those friendships that no longer serve me anymore. I'm not holding on to those fake love relationships that no longer serve me anymore, where I was given to them more than they were given to me. Some of you realize that you were in codependent relationships, that you were in relationships that were toxic, that were not healthy for you. Let's see, what else do you have for Scorpio? Look at that, gratitude. Fill me with gratitude for all you give. May I be a vehicle for you wherever I go. Look at you. You're so, this is beautiful, Scorpio. You're in the energy of gratitude. You're so grateful. And it's hard to say, oh, I'm grateful for the things that I've went through. But you are, Scorpio. You're like, I'm grateful for the things that I went through. Even the heartbreaks and the disappointments, I'm grateful for that. Because if I never would have went through that, I wouldn't be in this energy I am today. And I wouldn't be the person that I am today, where I'm vibing high. You know what I'm saying? I had to be taught by low vibrational people that I mattered more, that I was more important than what I was allowing to happen to myself. You know, you started loving on yourself. You started nurturing yourself. And you started realizing that some of the people you were surrounding yourself by weren't even on the same level as you. Okay, look, guidance. When you make divine intelligence your foundation, you finally have a fixed star to follow. A lot of you had to go through the things you went through to realize that you are on a way higher wavelength than the other people. And you have a mission in this life. You're realizing your purpose, and you're also realizing that not everybody in this lifetime will recognize that they have a purpose on this earth. Okay, let me say that again. You're realizing that a lot of people in this lifetime will not realize that they have a purpose on this earth, but you realize yours. You've awakened, and you're I feel like you're very grateful for being awakened at the time that you are, because baby, 2022 is smelling like money, love, and abundance. Okay, I don't know about y'all, but this is my year. I'm claiming it. I've claimed it. I've set my intentions, and I continue to set my intentions every freaking day. Look, yeah, goals. As I'm speaking, cracker. Yeah. I will continue to set them because I know that I am abundance and I deserve abundance in my life, right? And so a lot of you had to let go of low vibrational people here. And you're not even bitter. That's the thing. You're not even bitter. We got the Chariot card. Charge ahead with confidence. Stay strong and focused, Scorpio. Stay strong and focused here with this Chariot energy. Yeah, you're focused on that. You're moving forward. And you're balanced. That's the thing about the Chariot. You're very balanced here. Emotionally, physically, spiritually, you're balanced. And you're charging ahead towards your successes. Look, thorns. Weathering the challenges ahead will bring in a new and positive future. You know that there's more stuff that you got to go through. But you recognize, hey, in this gratitude energy, I know that there are lessons I need to learn. And I thank you for them so that I can continue to vibe in my higher energy. Give me one. Look, Phoenix, be prepared to be renewed after a period of crisis. See, a lot of you have went through your dark night of the soul. And although it was painful, you're realizing, hey, if it wasn't for that, I wouldn't be awakened right now. Give me one more for Scorpio with this deck. They gave me two. We got Mountain. Know that you are protected as you face challenges, but remain cautious. You are protected. You're being guided, okay, by your angels and ancestors, and you're being protected the whole entire time. Because, beware, be careful who you trust at this time, because there's people that's around you, again, low vibrational people, people that have bad intentions towards you. They're not liking that you're rising up. They're not liking that you're awakened and that you're committed to new beginnings and opportunities here. They hate. It's like they're mad at your success, Scorpio. Mirage, you are attracting emotional fulfillment and unconditional love. See, you're on a completely different wavelength than these other people. You are on a completely different wavelength than these other people. And some people are mad. They are salty. They are salty. But again, that's not your problem. You had to sacrifice them because they weren't willing to raise their vibration. That's not your problem. That's theirs. Everybody's life purpose is theirs alone. It's not yours to tell them, hey, I got to bring you with me. No. You're on your life purpose. You stay on your course. Let them figure their course out. You can help guide them. You can give them advice. But you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make them drink, right? We have 15, adrift in shallow water. Take a few deep breaths and reconnect to your inner peace. Notice the small things and appreciate them. Don't let nobody throw you off your energy, Scorpio. Because again, there are low vibrational people here with the beware, be careful who you trust at this time. There are low vibrational people that aren't happy for you. And that's okay, but don't let them interrupt your peace, okay? Let's see, what else do you have for Scorpio for the next 4 to 7 days? Look, 30, surrounded by prosperity. Your attention is being drawn to the infinite nature of reality. That which exists outside the known is beyond measure. You have no idea how much prosperity you are walking into, Scorpio. All because you're in this high vibration, you're focused, you're balanced, you're at peace. You're not holding any grudges. You don't have any fear. You're walking in your success, Scorpio. And people cannot stand it. There are people that cannot stand it. But remember, the key is to stay high vibrational. Don't let somebody throw you off. Don't let people come in and mess with your inner peace. Look. 4, life is better together. Seek assistance from your community. Connect with family, friends, or others who will support you. It can be as simple as making a phone call. Only surround yourself by the people that are supporting you, Scorpio. Not by the people that's talking down. Oh, you think you better than everybody? Or, oh, you think you too good to come around because now you on your spiritual journey. You think you better. No, it's not that. It's not that at all. It's just I'm grateful for this new opportunity. And that sacrifice card there, I had to let you go. Because you thought negative of me. You thought I was stupid. You thought that I wasn't going to be nothing. I wasn't going to get nowhere. You know, you had to let them go. Oh, well, you shouldn't do that. Oh, I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't put all that time and energy into that. You got to let go of them people. This could be exes, family members, friends. They come in all different shapes and sizes. Okay? They could be anyone. What else do you have for Scorpio for the next 4 to 7 days? So be careful of your energy the next couple of days, because there are some people that are going to test you. Okay? But don't let them throw you off, because you're in the energy of prosperity. You're attracting everything towards you. Don't let them distract you, Scorpio. Other messages you have. Grounding. Look, earth. Yeah. You're laying your foundation, Scorpio. You're laying your seeds. You're planting your seeds. Remember, right now, you're planting your seeds. What happens after planting them? You got to water them. You got to nurture them, right? And if you're busy over here in the grass, going off on somebody, getting into it with someone, and you're missing the good morning, because you know you got to water early in the morning before the sun come out, because it'll burn it up. If you over here arguing with somebody, you done missed your little sunrise, right, of watering the plants, you ain't going to have time to water. And what's that going to do? It's going to affect your fruit, okay, where you're trying to create fruition now. You're trying to make things grow. You're trying to make things prosper. Don't let people get you distracted, Scorpio. Don't let them get you distracted, okay? And you're going to also have people that's going to be trying to mooch off of you. They're highlighting these crows or these ravens on here. You're going to have people that's trying to mooch off of you, take from you here. Look how they're eating, okay? They're going to be trying to take from you. And they said, look at the bottom. Yeah, secret. So don't be sounding the alarm to everybody what you got going on, Scorpio. Be cautious of who you tell. I think I've been telling you that for the past few readings. Be cautious of who you're telling what you got going. Spirit, initiation, yeah. Yeah, initiation. You're being prepared for greatness, Scorpio. You are being prepared for greatness. This here is like a test you're going through right now here with the sacrifice and gratitude. Spirit is trying to make sure that you're ready. They're trying to make sure you're ready. Yeah, candles and magic. Some of you need to do a protection spell. Cleanse your energy with the white candle. Clear out the energy. And then turn around and burn your black candle for protection. Okay? Also, look up some more protection spells. Yeah, look, as I was saying, that protection came out. I told you. Make sure you get magic oracle. It says protection. Some of you need to do a protection spell. That's what I was getting. That's crazy. Pop right out. Some of you need to, yeah, awakening. See, a lot of you are waking up. And people are mad because they don't understand it. They don't understand what's going on. But you need to protect your energy. As soon as I get done, I'm going to go over there and light me a white candle. I'm going to let that burn. And then I'm going to light my black candle for protection. Okay? But you need to do some protection or protection energy. Look up some spells. You can do these little spells. I don't know if some of you are into witchcraft and things like that. But you can do these little glass spells here. And you put like cinnamon. I can't remember the recipe. But you put it in there and you plant it in your yard. Or you put it in your house. Put it around your house as well. It helps protect your energy. You can make a necklace out of it. Bracelet. Whatever you want to do. But protect your energy, Scorpio. Also, not just spiritually, but mentally, physically, emotionally, protect your energy as well. Give me another one. What else you need Scorpio to know? What else you need Scorpio to know? Incubation and power. Yeah, you're being, Scorpio, you're about to be so damn powerful. You're about to be so damn powerful to the point where you can say, I want this, and snap your fingers and it happens. You're in incubation right now. You're being prepared for this power, Scorpio. And spirit is basically testing you to make sure that you're gonna use the power the way it's supposed to be, in that high vibrational love energy. Like, you're gonna be giving out love. You're not gonna be trying to, I hope you grow a wart on your face and a big mole on your face. Like, they wanna make sure you're not doing that. They wanna make sure you're operating in the energy of love and light. That's what they're doing. That's what's going on right now. That's why you're in incubation. You're seeing who needs to be around you. You're seeing people for who they truly are. You might have had a friend that you thought was your best friend in the world, and they just started turning on you. It's because spirit is showing you for who they truly are, because you're about to walk into greatness. You're about to walk into prosperity. And who wants that fake ass person with them as they walking into this, mooching off of them? Okay, like the little ravens and the crows here. Who wants that type of energy around them? Some of you is a lover. A lover that you've been with, you've known for a while, but all they want to do is mooch off of you. Who wants that in their life? And so what's happening is you're being protected here in this incubation energy, where people are trying to come and reach in, but they can't because you're protected. Again, do your protection spells. Make sure these energies aren't around you. What's at the bottom? Yeah, intensification. You got this in your last reading. Your powers are about to be magnified. Like, they're about to be so strong, Scorpio, to the point where, again, you can just say it and it manifests. You know what I'm saying? I make $600,000 a year. Boom. Money going to start flowing in just like that. It's going to be coming from places you can't even imagine. Opportunities happening for you you've never even seen. You're being prepared, Scorpio. You are being prepared. It's about to be beautiful. What else do you have? Thoughts. Keep your thoughts positive, Scorpio. Yeah, sudden wealth. Family room. Keep your thoughts positive. Child, look, you're being protected again. You're being protected. Incubation is like that childlike energy. You're being prepared and prepped and protected here. Getting ready for this power here. Like you're being charged. Because you're about to be so strong. Thoughts, sudden wealth, and family room. This is all you've been thinking about right here. Keep those thoughts positive at all times. Because you're about to be so successful and so abundant, Scorpio. You have no freaking idea what is coming in towards you here. No freaking idea. And remember, the people that are no longer in your life, okay, allow them to fall wayside. Some of you is family members, but you're about to be prepared for the home you want, the type of lifestyle you want, the type of money that you want to come in. All of that you think and dream and wish for is coming. You're surrounded by the prosperity energy. You're on the right wavelength, which is the energy of love, the frequency of love. You're manifesting. So keep doing that, Scorpio. Don't let somebody negative come in and throw you off. And remember to always have gratitude. Always have gratitude. Which I see you doing that, so it's good. Always have gratitude. Look, lover's energy, toil and labor, child, and unexpected income. I told you. All right, Scorpio, this is what I have for you. I love you guys so much. Remember, vibe high and keep them motherfuckers at bay. All right? Love you guys so much. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.